Amen. Hallelujah. Once again, we're so happy to be able to come your way on It's Web TV. This is your host, Bishop W.J. Campbell, pastor of Divine Deliverance Church, and we're glad about it. I want you to call a friend up and tell a friend to tune in to Web TV. All you got to do is have access to the internet. Amen. And you can watch me live and in living color. Praise God. Amen. We're so happy once again that God have afforded us this opportunity just to come and share the word of God with you. Praise the Lord. Amen. For the word of God let us know that when we pray a faithful prayer, there's no doubt in my mind that God hears and answers prayer. Because the Bible says when praises go up, blessings come down. So now prayers are universal, that some way, somehow, God will go before you and make ease and success your way. Praise God. Amen. I was going to go in the Word of God quickly. Amen. Praise God. In the book of Matthew, the 5th chapter, verse 13. Say, we are the salt of the earth. And now if the salt lose its saltness, how can it make me safe again? It's no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled by men. You are the light of the world. Amen. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it on a bowl. Instead, they put it on a stand and give light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. Amen. I just want to let you know that we are the salt of the earth. I know today that many of you are hearing me right now and you're in a certain situation and you just don't know what to do. Why not take to Jesus? Tell him all about the situation. For God hears and God answers prayer. As you notice on my left, you're looking at these two blessed angels. I always have them with my present when I'm at home. Or, amen. I even got a little angel in my car as I'm driving. Praise God. These are blessed angels. Amen. And a little later on into our sermon, I'm going to talk to you about the angels and tell you why it's important that you have one. Now, you cannot buy these at the store. These are ordered from me. Amen. The order is a special order. Amen. And it's tailored to your needs, your wants, and your desire. Amen. Praise go up and blessings come down. I don't know about you, but Lord, I'm in need of your healing. I'm in need of your blessings. Amen. Praise God. Amen. I just want to slow the pace down and just to let you know that God is able. He's a right now deliverer. He can bring you through whatever you're going through. A lot of times we get stressed out and we feel that we cannot make the journey any longer, but God sent all of us to a test. We must suffer just as Jesus did. Must he bear the cross alone? No, there's one for you and there's one for me. We all have to bear that cross, just as Jesus did. But those of you that believe in him and stand firm on his word, he'll certainly bring you through. Amen. Today is a special day because God made it. He made it for you and he made it for I. He woke us up early this morning while we was yet closed in our right mind and breathed the breath of life in our body. Oh, Lord, I'm so thankful Lord, I'm so grateful for you touching little me. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Well, I want to make some announcements and get them out of the way. Amen. I had a piece of paper. I don't know what I did with it. Praise God. Amen. There, so much is going on. They have a seminar this week on finance and how you can make money and keep your money that you're making. Amen. I had it, but I missed it. I may have left it in the office. Praise God. After the break, I'll find it. I'll talk to you more, a little more about it. Amen. Hallelujah. But listen to me very carefully. Praise God. I want to go in the book of Exodus for a moment here. These two angels, they are not ordinary angels. They are special angels with a special touch. These angels are designed for peoples like you and like me that want to be successful in the everyday walks of life, want to be able to enjoy some of the benefit that God has provided for you. You see, whatever you see, you can have it. See, I would like to leave this station tonight and go and catch me a plane and go overseas and, amen, and have breakfast in the morning time and come back the same next day. Amen. Those are my desire. Amen. What about you? What are some of the things that you want out of life? You see, a lot of us have stopped dreaming. You know, when you're a little child growing up, you used to have so many dreams. I want to be this. I want to be a school teacher. I want to be a lawyer. I want to be a doctor. There's many things you want to be, but you didn't keep going forward on your dream. You sort of put it on the back burner. Praise God. Amen. Somebody said, well, you know, I had the opportunity to work for one of the big three, and that was a good job, good paying job. Amen. So, yes, it was. A lot of us were able to take care of families and loved ones because the employment, amen, was there, and the income, the salary was nice. You might have put in many hours, but you got paid from the hours that you put in, praise God. And from that, you were able to provide for your family. But now things have changed. It takes a lot to raise a family. Everything is sky high. And when you're putting out more you got coming in, you're robbing Peter trying to pay Paul. This blessed angels is going to help you. It's going to help you sort of level the playing field a little bit. Praise God. You're going to have an angel in your surrounding praying along with you. Praise God. And I don't know about you, but I always want something praying along with me, or something that would bring success and prosperity my way. How many of you are hearing my voice right now desire to have prosperity in your life? Praise God. You don't have to have a doctor's degree. You don't have to have all that education and the degrees to have prosperity. Amen. For my God is able. All you got to do is give your life to Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. And keep on saying, Lord, I'm your child. And Lord, if you take care of me the way I go and feed me and clothe me, Lord, I will do your will. Praise God. Well, it can happen. Let us go into the word of God quickly from the book of Exodus. Amen. The 14th chapter, verse 19. Amen. The book of Exodus, 14th chapter, verse 19. And the angel of God, which went before the camp of Israel, removed and went behind them, and the pillar of cloud went before their face and stood behind them. Amen. Huh? The angel of God now. The angel of God, praise God, went in the camp of Israel and removed and went behind them. And the pillar of cloud went before their face and stood behind them. Let us think for a moment. Lord Father God, we know today that we cannot do anything without you moving and directing. Lord, right now we thank you for your word. Most of all, we thank you for being who you are, Father. The Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end. Lord, we come before you as a full 54 empty fountains and thanking you for the many blessings. But right now, Father, we see that we are in a situation that have got a toehold on my life. It looks like every time I try to raise up, something is there pulling me down. I don't know what it is, but Father God, please, sir, tell me what I must do. Or show me the way that I should go, Lord. Lord, I am your child. Lord, I cannot do it by myself. I heard one writer said, how long must I wait? I come to tell you this night, not long, saints of God, my God is able to bring you through. I have in my possession, these angels are God's blessed angels. And every saint of God that's hearing me right now, every one of you that's seeing this broadcast on Web TV, and you find that you're in a chaotic situation, seeing that those spirits is all around you trying to force you to do things that you don't want to do, even trying to throw a monkey wrench in the plan and stop your progress. See, one thing about it, see, Satan knows when the good Lord is ready to move you up the king's highway, and he will get busy as a bumblebee, trying to put that sting on you, trying to turn you around, trying to make you think that you can't get through, trying to make you think that things won't work in your behalf. But I come to tell you tonight, as I've seen, as I've heard, the good thing that God has in store for you that believe in his word. I want to stand on the promise of God tonight and know that he'll bring me through whatever I'm going through. These angels. Hallelujah. It's about five different designs of these angels. And I'm saying to you tonight, if you have been experiencing difficulty trying to make odds and ends meet, someone's right now saying, I've been trying to find employment, but it seems like nothing is working. I have the right credentials, but it seems like no one wants to hire me. I tell you this one thing. Why not get an angel and place it in your home? Get you a blessed angel. And I can say this one thing. This angel will work for you. Hallelujah. All you got to do is try. See, some of you don't want to try. Amen. You see, anything that's worth having, you're going to have to give a little extra. Or go an extra mile. Praise God. Hallelujah. You see, a lot of folks want something for nothing. And when that happens, it would not work for you. You know, I thought about, I had a Jewish friend of mine. He's a good friend. Amen. When I met him when I first got my first office there on Wyoming. And he was one of the people that owned the building. Matter of fact, he owned one building. He owned the whole block. Praise God. And he was one that he didn't need any money, but he, you know, he wanted to keep money coming his way, praise God. And so what happened one week, I had to go to meet him at his house because I hadn't paid my rent, amen. And you know, them Jewish folks, when rent is due, they want their money, praise God. So he told me I'd come out there, and when I went there, amen, he opened the door. The first thing I saw, there was a look kind of right up over the door as you walked through the door. Praise God. And there was candles burning, and praise God. See, they believe in having things in their surroundings that would cause success to continue to flow. And this was my thing about enable you to be successful, or that would make things happen for you. Amen. You see, wanting is one thing, but doing is nothing. See, a lot of people want, but you don't want to do nothing to get what you want. Amen. See, if you're going to continue to sit on your bottom, all the things you're going to have is the bottom. I don't want the bottom. I want the top. Give me mines off the top. This God's blessed angel, praise God, is something that you're going to have in your home that's going to be working for your behalf. Someone saying, "Well, listen. How can I purchase one? What's the price of one?" Amen. A young lady called me and she said, "Bishop, I saw the broadcast, amen, on web TV, but you was talking about the angel, but you didn't say how much it was." Praise God. Well, I'm gonna let you know. Hallelujah. I'm gonna let you, because this us, you have to call in. These are special order now. You just can't come and get one. Amen. No, I don't work like that. Because this is going to be tailored to you. See, everybody's needs are not the same. Before I can ship this angel to you, or you can pick it up, I have to have a little background about you as an individual. Because I want to this angel to pick up your condition, your needs, and your wants. Somebody said that's hocus pocus. Well, if I tell you that a hen will dip snuff, only thing you got to do is hatch the hen's wing, and you'll see the snuff box there. Amen. And if I tell you that, and you do it, you believe it then. Praise God. I tell you what thus saith the Lord. Amen. Now, the way that you can receive this best angel is simple. Praise God. Sit down right now and address a letter to me. Amen. Now, someone, you said, Bishop, I want to be blessed so I can be a blessing to my church, or I want to do something for my family. Praise God. But you need to have something extra working in your behalf. Praise God. And I don't want anything else that I'd rather have in my possession. Is one of God's best angels, blessed by the man of God. Amen. Now, sit down right now. Don't worry about Daniel's. Hallelujah. Don't worry about him. God brought him. Brought him through. God brought him through. Locked the jaws of lion. Praise God. Hallelujah. Somebody right now saying, I'm just like Sly in the family stone. Thank you, Lord, for letting me be myself. Saints of God. That all-important mail address is Bishop W.J. P.O. Box, 211-13, Detroit, Michigan. Zip 48221. Now, it's important. Because, there are thousands of saints of God right now that's watching this program. You're in a financial rut. Things are happening that have never happened before. and you just don't know what have happened. Look like you stepped in something and you just can't get it unglued from it. Praise God. Grandma had another word for it. But I wanted to share something with you that I know beyond a shadow of a doubt. It's going to be a great blessing. See, I don't know about you, but I believe in the blessing of God. For God said, if you believe it, you can receive it. So I want you that's got faith today, you believe in the supernatural power of an almighty God. For he says, what I have 10,000 blessings in one hand alone just to satisfy the poor and needy. Amen. And so I just want to share what's one with you. Just one. That it might be exactly what you need to get things moving. And once again, that's P.O. Box 211-13, Detroit, Michigan, zip 48221. See, I believe in dreams. I believe in vision. I believe that God can tell you sweet things, good things that can help you to move up the King's Highway. Whatever you do, please, ma'am, please, sir, don't take my dreams. Don't stop my vision. See, and that's what happened to somebody right now. Just watch this program. Something has stopped you from dreaming. Something has stopped you from seeing. And you need something that could be direct contact with you. That's where this blessed angel going to come and play. Praise God. It had been dressed and anointed by a man of God. This is God's blessed angel. And if I were you, I would make sure while they're lasting, they're not going to last too long, have one in my possession. Now, the donation, amen, because there's some extra material that I had to get, so I had to take it up a little bit, amen. There's a $30 donation. I didn't say 30 cents. I said $30. That's a 3 and an O, a dot, and 2 more zeros. Amen. Now, I don't know what the shipping is. Amen. Praise God. But I'm going to let you know, if you want to receive one, you must send in your $30 faith offering to aid this ministry. And I'm going to ship it back to you. Now, first off, what you do. You write me. You say, Bishop, I want to have one of those God's blessed angels. Amen. Praise God. Then I want you to write down a little history about yourself. Amen. The situation that you have it. Amen. You see, everybody's problem not the same. Amen. Somebody might say, well, listen, my thing is I need some money. Amen. And someone might be lonely. They might need a God to bless them with a companion. Amen. Somebody might desire to want to take a trip somewhere. Or somebody just might need someone to pray for peace and in their home, in their life, in their surrounding, around their family. Amen. So everybody's problem situation is not the same. But listen, this angel that I want to send you, this blessed God's angel that I want to share with you, is going to make a difference. So therefore, I must know, have a little background on that which you are having in your life, so that the angel, praise God, when I pray with the angel, when I bless the angel, praise God, and before I ship it back to you, already the contact will be taking place. Somebody said, there's a change coming, and I want to be in that number. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. Listen, saints of God, it's a poor dog that don't wag his own tail. Amen. You see, God has blessed me in an awesome way. God has given me this angel to bless a multitude of peoples that's in captivity right now, and you can't seem to find the way. Somebody's in prison, in other words. And there's no jailer with a key. But I come to tell you, Dr. Jesus had dispatched to you God's blessed angel Hallelujah. That can unlock the door. Only thing you got to do is have one. Once again, if you want one, write me. Amen. Now listen, I know somebody said, well, listen, Bishop, I need to pray. Listen, only thing you need to have this blessed angel, and don't worry about being prayed for. You're going to watch and see how the results is going to change in your life. Praise God. You're going to see how things are going to get better for you. Praise the Lord. Just by having this blessed angel in your possession. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. I'm getting kind of warm here. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Listen to me. Praise God. Hallelujah. I want to look at another verse. Amen. Praise God. And I'm going to be very brief. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. They usually give me water, but I guess they don't give me no water tonight. Praise God. I know the bishop's thirsty. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. I get a little thirsty, so I better get a little thirsty. Have a little water. Somebody home needs to give me some water. Give me a glass of water. Praise God. And set it there. I'll come by in the spirit and pick it up. Amen. I want to read this verse quickly. Amen. Then I'm going to take a break. Hallelujah. And Psalms 91 and 11, it says this. For he shall give his angel charge over thee to keep in all thy way. What? It says he shall give his angel in charge over thee. I got the blessed angel. Hallelujah. There are five different designs. There's just two of them. I had another one, but it didn't want to come with me. The other three didn't, so I let them stay and rest. But these are God's blessed angels. They have been special blessed. I want you to have one. When I come back, praise God, I'm going to tell you more about the angels, how it's important as us, or you or me, pray us, you know, that's what's so common word that we always use, should have one. If you want things to get better in your life, if you want success, if you might just got a new job and you're catching it from here and there. You know how when you're a new kid on the block, a new job, and you know how everybody, they want to see what type of material you made out of, amen. They give you the dirty part of the job, amen, just to see can you take it, amen. But then you need to have this blessed agent in your behalf that's going to go before you and fight the battle. You see what I'm saying? Listen, we're going to take a break and we're going to be right back. Amen. Praise God. Stick and stay.
When you
the Lord. Thanks. Amen. I'm back now. Still drinking this water. And cooled me off, so I'm ready to go on, head on now. Listen, I just want you to know that I'm a real person. There's nothing fake about Bishop W.J. I'm just one, just an ordinary individual that loves people. And I want to help everybody, to let them know they are somebody. And you can have whatever you want. God wants you to have the very best of everything. Amen. I said earlier that I will hit somebody, I will talk about the money smarts. Amen. In the Chronicle this week, they had the article, Money Smarts Week, Michigan Focus on Consumer Education. On April the 20th, Federal Reserve Bank of Chicago and Detroit Bank will kick off Money Smart Week for 2013. From April 20th through the 27th, Federal Reserve Bank of Chicago, along with financial institutions, government agents, and community groups, educators, organizers, and financial experts will host more than 130 events statewide. Create, educate, and to help consumers better manage their finance. Amen. Now, it's to help you better manage your finance. Now, if you ain't got nothing to manage, that's kind of hard. Amen. But I want to put you in a position where you have something to manage. Then you can go and be in on this. Amen. So, listen, I want to see how the big cats do it. How they keep getting more money with the little money they have. There's a secret. Amen. When you know the formula and the secret, then you can be on top. You know, I'll never forget. I went to Marygrove College, and I took up our stocks and bonds. And it was maybe about 20-some years ago. And when I took it up, I just want to know how the guys get money out of stocks and bonds. And it was amazing. And if I had kept with it, who knows what might have happened. But I couldn't, took it up. And I see now that, you know, a lot of people have stocks, know how to cash it in when it's supposed to. I had some at a crisis stock, the price was beginning to get going down. I got rid of my stock. Amen. Praise God. If I kept it, I might have been all right. But I got rid of it too quick. Amen. And had some stock in GM and got rid of it too quick. Amen. Praise God. But listen, that's over with. But I got a different outlook, different thought. And because I got the God's best angel on my side. Amen. Listen to me very carefully. I don't know if you want to know what this seminar is going on this week. Amen. I thought they might have an address in the paper here, but I don't see any address. Amen. Only thing you know, just go and Google it on the internet. You can find anything you want to find on the World Wide Web. That's all you got to do. Type up Money Seminar and Google it, and it'll tell you what's going on. That's all you got to do. Amen. Now, some of y'all don't know nothing about the computer. You find somebody that knows what's about it and tell them. Amen. Praise God. Listen, we're going to go back, and I'm going to talk to you a little more. You know, I was saying, tell you about Daniels. Amen. There's a scripture that fits well with the blessed angels. Praise God. Hallelujah. Daniels, amen, the sixth chapter, the book of Daniel, sixth chapter of the book of Daniel, and verse 22. Amen. And I just want to read this for you. And I want you to hear me with your spiritual ear. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. It says this. And I'm reading out the Study Word Bible, so you might have King James. The word might be a little different. Amen. I just want to make sure that we're on the same page. Praise God. It says this: My God has sent his angels, and has shut the lion's mouth. Hello, somebody. My God. Now, suppose that the lion's got you, but in a sense. Suppose Satan has got you tied, the bills are about to drown you, amen, hallelujah, and you can't get out, the door's closed. You can't get out. Hallelujah. It says here, shut the lion's mouth, that they have not hurt me, for as much as before him in mourning was found in me, and also before thee, O king, I have done no hurt. O king, I have done no hurt. Now God sent an angel to Daniel and just blocked the jaws of the lion. What a mighty God we serve. And I'm just got an angel here that for you to be blessed, and you're saying that you don't believe it'll work. Try. I double D dare you to try. I thought about that man that had a wine, and he was doing something, and he said, Lord, it broke. He said, Lord, I hope that's not my bottle. I hope it's not my bottle. The Lord, because that's the last bottle I got. Amen. But when he looked, it wasn't a bottle. It was something else that had busted in his pocket. So God was favorable to him and let that bottle stay whole just for him. Amen. So I'm saying to you that's hearing me right now, things can change if you got a mind. See, you have to have made up mind. My Father is awesome in everything, but you have to be willing to go forward. Some people are as satisfied as they are. You know, in my imagine, I have a big book, and in this book I got things I want to accomplish, things I want to do in my lifetime. And when I reach a certain level, I cross them off. Praise God. You should have a dream book, a dream catalog of things that you want to do in your lifetime. If you want to take a trip, you want a car, home, or just whatever you want to. See, I would love to go and see other parts of the world. Venture out. See what other folks are doing, other cultures. Amen. Why not go to Japan in the morning time and come back in the evening time? Why not go to Italy, France, Barbados? There's nothing wrong with that. You cannot live but once. Enjoy life. That's what the blessed angel of God is about. To enable you to enjoy life more abundantly. Because you'll be free from all the world and your thoughts will be much clearer. Praise God. Hallelujah. Listen, someone right now. I don't know how much time we got left, but someone's right now that's hearing my voice. The Spirit of God is saying, "Why, if you want to be one of the ones to have this blessed angel, say, why not call and tell Bishop Campbell that you're on board with him?" Amen. The number I want you to call tonight is 1-248-996-8954. I'll just call if you want me to pray for you. If there's a problem. But this blessed angel that's before me, you haven't seen anything like it. Wherever you are right now, listen, seeing this broadcast. If I were you, and things in my surroundings was not going the way I want them to be, look like nothing is going right for me. Last year was up and hill and down, and the first 3 months of this year has been awesome. I mean, it's been awesome. And you want a change to take place? You want the better things? I want you to have one of God's blessed angels in your possession. They are special. They are blessed. Call. Let's call. I want to pray with you. 248-996-8954. 996-8954. By the way, our church is located 15819 Wyoming, between Puritan and Pilgrim, Divine Deliverance Church. Beginning in the month of May, praise God. I don't want to go back, praise God. The month of May, we're going to start our religious store. All types of religious goods will be available for you. Amen. I'm going to be telling you more about that in the weeks to come. Amen. And I'm excited about it. Praise God. Amen. Listen, I need you to call. Amen. Someone call and say, Bishop Cameron, I believe that that angel will help me if I receive one. All you got to do is make that seed of faith offering of $30 to aid this outreach ministry. Matter of fact, if you do it this week, I'm going to ship it to you free. That's the type of spirit I have. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. If you do it this week, I'm going to ship it for free. The shipping is on me. Now, you can't beat that with a stick. Because I got a special box I had to put in. Have to wrap it special. Praise God. Amen. Call me. I want someone to call in right now. 248-996-8954. You that believe in the power of God, call right now. Amen. 248-996-8954. Amen. Every Wednesday at 1 o'clock, we have Bible study. We have a prayer service of praises in the morning. Amen. From 8 to 9. From 8 to 12. I mean, praise God. Hallelujah. You can just come and amen. And we also have a word that we'd like to share with you pertaining to your finance. Praise God. Amen. God is good all the time. Amen. And He's worthy to be praised. Amen. As we're getting ready to go a little further, praise God, I'm excited. I'm excited to know that you can be in on this if you move and act right now. See, somebody's going to wait till the very end and say, I should have. Then it'd be too late. Praise God. Listen, there's a verse I want to share with you. Amen. Praise God. Before we close out our broadcast this evening. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. In the Word of God, taken from the book of Acts, the 12th chapter, verse 7. Amen. It says, and behold, the angel of the Lord came upon him, and light shining in the prison. What do you want to say? And the angel of the Lord came upon him, and the light shined in the prison. Peter on the side, and raising up and saying, arise up quickly, and the chains fell from his hand. Hallelujah. Father God, we come right now to say thank you for every saint of God that have watched this program tonight. Lord, I may not know them name by name. Lord, I may not know the situation. But Lord, I'm at you right now, Father God, you go before them and touch them. Lord, whatever they're going through, whatever problem they're facing right now, whatever challenges they're having in their life, Lord, let them know, Father God, you the caring God and the concerned God. Lord, let my words go before them right now. I'm asking you to open the windows of heaven and pour out your mind and bless upon them, Father God, where there won't be room and the store I receive it. Lord, I cannot do, but you can't go into the hospital, the sick room, the comfort zone, or wherever the saints of God might be. Lord, bless them. And Lord, I'm asking you to bless those in Baltimore. Hallelujah. Those that lost Boston, that tragic that happened on today. Bless those men and family lost a loved one. Bless them, Father God. Lord, we know the enemy is on the loose. but we bind them up in Jesus' name. Lord, we know that you have all power in the palm of your hand. Lord, we ask you to bless your children here and there, everywhere. And Lord, I'm actually to bless this web TV station. Bless it with your blessing, Father God. Lord, we know Satan is on the loose. Satan trying to come and destroy. But Lord, we know we're standing on your word. Hallelujah. No form of weapons will come against you, for we stand on the word of God. Lord, I know beyond a shadow of a doubt, for we plead in the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Saints of God, we've come to the end of our broadcast. Praise God. Oh, I got some more time, I guess. Praise God. I'm wrapped up in the Spirit. Hallelujah. I thought my time had came and go. Listen, I guess as the angels are already going forth working. Praise God. Hallelujah. Listen, I thought about when Peter was in prison and the angel went in and the shackles fell from him. I know if you get one of these blessed angels in your home, praise God, where you've been in a chaotic situation, something good is going to happen for you. All thing you got to do is believe. Pick up that phone right now. Call me. Call Bishop W.J. right now. 248-996-8954. That's 248-996-8954. Or you can call the church. Leave a message. If no one's there, let's leave a message on the recorder. I will return the call. But in the meantime, those of you in Michigan, Detroit, Pontiac, or wherever this broadcast is being seen, and if you are experiencing difficulty, when I say difficulty, that means trouble, bad luck, no luck. Hallelujah. The landlord rang your front door bell and you went and you asked him what was on his mind. He said, money, honey. Well, if you experience something similar to that, then I want you to hear what I'm saying right now. God's blessed angel will help you to overcome that problem. Only thing you got to do is right in and say, Bishop W, I want to receive one of the blessed angels. And as a matter of fact, put your phone numbers in your letter because I want to call you because I have to have a personal contact with you. That's P.O. Box 211-13, Detroit, Michigan, zip 48221. P.O. Box now, 211-13, Detroit, Michigan, zip 48221. And just write your name down and your telephone number. Hallelujah. Don't forget now, there's a $30 faith offering. Amen. And the shipping is free. Praise God. Listen, I got to sort of get to leave you, but don't forget, the blessed angel is what you need in your household. Every Sunday morning at 11 a.m., we have meet our praise worship service here at Divine Deliverance. 15819. We actually come and be with us every Sunday morning. Praises go up and blessings come down. We love you and we're praying with you. Remember, if God can't do it, it just can't be done. Don't forget about the blessed angel. You need to have one. God bless you. And we love you very, very much.